Dear Master Course participants, friends, guests, what a spectacular bird's eye view of Keshet Eilon campus we saw just now. This summer, at this campus, we plan to celebrate together with you Keshet Eilon's 30th anniversary. COVID-19 prevented us from commemorating this event at Kibbutz Eilon, but it would not stop us from celebrating virtually. During the next hour, we will travel from Keshet Eilon's first modest steps in 1990 through its major milestones to the present day. This presentation we dedicating to the friends of Keshet Eilon committees around the world, because without their continuous and loyal support, we would not be able to make our music for 30 years. It is all started in 1989, when the Jeunesse Musicale of Israel organized camp for 100 young Israeli musicians up to age 18. It incorporated many instruments under the motto Music, Fun and Holiday. I was invited together with Annie Schnarch, my wife, to be in charge of this camp. By 1989, Annie and I had moved from Israel to London. I was teaching already at the Royal College of Music, violin, and Annie was developing her performing career. To this camp, we brought from United Kingdom a group of 14 students who performed in front of the kibbutz members. Now, Jeunesse Musicale arrived at Kibbutz Eilon at the invitation of a local music teacher by name Gilad Sheba, whose dream was to bring music to his kibbutz and enrich cultural life of its members. Gilad grew up at the Kibbutz Eilon, which already had a rich musical tradition. It has been created by the founders of the kibbutz, who made music a central value in their lives and passed their passion on to the second generation. It was clear to Gilad that there was a ready-made audience of music lovers who would be delighted to welcome young musicians at the kibbutz. I invited my friend Amnon Weinstein, the violin maker, or as one of newspapers called him, the famous dreamer from Tel Aviv, because he always had so many ideas. His creativity seems didn't have borders. Anyway, Amnon came to kibbutz for 3 days to check that the students' violins were in good playing condition in intense Israeli summer heat. Little did I know that this brief visit would change our lives. On the second day, I saw Amnon walking with his wife Asi on the way to the dining hall, gesticulating excessively. "What is the problem?" I asked, and received an astonishing answer. "This kibbutz is an ideal place for our master course." "But Amnon, we already have our master course, here and now," was my reply. "No, you don't understand," he responded. "We will create a master course here independent of Jeunesse Musicale for you students and advanced Israeli violinists." The next day, a meeting was organized at Gilad's home, at which Gilad, Amnon, Ani, I, and Dov Sheba, Gilad's father, explored the possibility of establishing a new master course. Here I must say a few words about a very dear man, Dov Sheba. Dov, one of the founders of Kibbutz Eilon in 1938, was a prominent figure in the kibbutz movement and a truly extraordinary person. Gilad inherited his instinctive administrative talent, his fundraising skills, and his special warm way of connecting to people. At the meeting, Dov said, "My wish is that my grandchildren, instead of having to travel to Tel Aviv to enjoy culture, will experience Tel Aviv's culture at the kibbutz alone. Then I asked Dov a simple question. What will happen if this new master course turns out to be too expensive to run and we will lose money? He answered, you musicians take care of the music and we will take care of the rest. This answer was the beginning of my personal belief that we might have a future at the kibbutz Eilon. So the following summer, the first Keshet Eilon master course took place. On the screen you see the participants of this first master course, the pioneers of Keshet Eilon. Even the name of Keshet Eilon didn't exist by then. It was just music camp. Faculty of three violin professors, Artur Zisserman, Anish Narch, and I, pianist Galina Zonis, Andy Robinson, and Jeanne Rosenberg, and 14 students, 7 from abroad, and 7 new immigrants from the former Soviet Union. And administration, or to be more precise, just one administrator, Gilad Sheba. You see him on the picture, on the corner, on the right side, and he was always in shorts, so we really called him the director in shorts by that time. And to start with, we were really, really fortunate. During the 1990s, a huge wave of new immigrants from the Soviet Union arrived to Israel, many of them musicians. They infused new energy into the social and cultural life of the country and played and still play. And I, one of them, basically, yes? So they still play an important part in the success of Keshet Eilon. But this first master course laid the foundations of Keshet Eilon with many, many of its distinctive features retained throughout the next 30 years. So what are features? So first of all, very warm relationship between kibbutz members and the master course participants. The special feeling of belonging to this place we received from the first day in the kibbutz. And then even the daily structure remained the same as in the first master course throughout 30 years. Individual lessons in the morning, master classes in the afternoon, concerts in the evening, and archery. This would make really Keshet Eilon different from many other courses because we incorporating the sport. The archery was introduced, of course, by violin maker Amnon Weinstein, who himself was archer at the Hapoel Givatayim sport club. And we managed to combine this violin study with archery sport, which incredibly required the same muscles, posture, the hand-eye coordination as violin playing, precision. This blend of music making and archery continues to contribute to the uniqueness of Keshet Eilon to this day. So what happened after this master course? Immediately after master course, a few months after this, the name of Keshet Eilon was invented. It was suggested by Tulin Weinberger, one of our earliest supporters and wonderful founders who believed in Keshet Eilon vision from the day one. And we salute all these founders after 30 years. The establishment of the Keshet Eilon non-profit organization was publicly announced at the festive concert at Tel Aviv Conservatory on December 18, 1990. The speakers were Amnon Weinstein, Gilad Sheba, and Shlomo Mintz. Shlomo Mintz supported Keshet Eilon from the beginning, but he joined Keshet Eilon in the 1994 as a patron and a faculty member, and he really contributed a lot to the development of Keshet Eilon. And surprise performer at the first concert, at the first Keshet Eilon Gala concert at Tel Aviv Conservatory, was 16-year-old new immigrant who was brought to the concert hall directly from the airport. His name was Maxim Vengerov, and he performed at that concert Bach Chaconne. We will see now the extract from his performance in 1990. Thank you. Young Maxim Vengerov, just to tell you that he's back this summer to Kibbutz Eilon after 30 years, and he will be giving masterclass on the 7th of August, so you are all most welcome. And now, during the first decade of Keshet Eilon, the heart of this musical activity was at the Sandwich Club. It was actually a renovated chicken coop, which we call it the world's most famous chicken coop. The atmosphere there was really hard to describe. Full house, only 100 seats, but always full house all the time, tightly packed with audience, music lovers, who always, almost hugging the performance, definitely not COVID-19 situation. But let's now watch 11-year-old Sergei Khachaturian playing Bach Prelude from the Partita No. 3 for violin solo at the 1996 master course at the Sandwich Club. Sandwich Club. And now in 2001 we opened the doors of our beautiful concert hall named after our first chairman of Israeli board, Mayor Borian. Here we see the opening with plaques and of donors. And this really, really beautiful concert hall became a milestone in the development of Keshet Eilon as it provided a modern day conditions. You can see a concert hall inside. Condition for performance. There's excellent acoustics, very comfortable conditions for the performance backstage, and of course 250 audience seats, very comfortable. And this is a really place to perform. I was saying if somebody can succeed in this concert hall, Carnegie Hall will be really a children playground. So we as well opened a new library. You can see now the old derelict silo barn, which was transformed into a really spectacular, beautiful, beautiful library and atelier for violin bow making. Many friends in Israel and abroad, as well as several foundations, helped us with generous donations that enabled to turn these two old unused structures in the agricultural area of the kibbutz into two usable buildings bursting with life and the music. And we always can smell and hear neighborly the cows, cow shed, so we know that we're still in the kibbutz. And it is important as well to mention that this library contains a lot of music from private collections donated by musicians and organizations. We have a very large collection of the rare editions of out of print. So if anybody looking for music and you cannot find it anywhere, you know that you can find it at Kibbutz Eilon. And we as well mounted a collection of violins and bows donated by many individuals throughout the years. So we're loaning these instruments to the young talented students in need who cannot afford to buy the instruments. And now during the first 20 years of existence, Keshet Eilon was exclusively the violin masterkurs. They call it violin land. There were partisan attempts to introduce viola to this curriculum, but these attempts were unsuccessful. We just didn't have facility to expand. So the condition for viola and cello to join Keshet Eilon family ripened in 2011. So we see here the viola ensemble, and in the next picture we see cello ensemble. So this expansion allows us to enrich the concert programs and to create chamber music ensembles at which faculty and students are playing together. So the question, who are the people behind this phenomenon Keshet Eilon? So I will start with faculty, because this is the real treasure of Keshet Eilon, is its outstanding international faculty. You can see here the picture from the 1992, with faculty together with students again, Gilad sitting on the left side in shorts, tradition. And this was our first steps. We can find among our faculty really unique range of the different approaches to teaching and playing. Over the years, we have, you know, witnessed many, many unforgettable masterclasses, which prove the entrance into the laboratory of violin playing, today viola and cello playing. Now we will see as well the photo of the last summer master course. Here we can see our faculty. So despite on the different personalities and temperaments, you will always find a common demeanor in these masterclasses. It's the desire of all our faculty members to share their unparalleled experience and knowledge. And of course, I must mention our pianist, because on this photograph, you see now as well all our pianists sitting together with faculty. They are not always on the spotlight, but their presence is essential at all the lessons and masterclasses and the concerts. So really, thank you, our dear faculty and pianists, for making master course so special. And this faculty, really like magnet, attracting the most talented students from around the world. And I will show you now the photographs from the last summer course. Really, we can see here people who will conquer the stages around the world in the very near future, if not already now. We as well were privileged to have among our faculty distinguished guest artists. I want to mention here Chaim Taub, who today turned 95, so again was incredible masterclass. And again, Chaim, Mazal Tov, you know, happy birthday, 95, so you're already a mature person now. So, but we still have many years to move together with you. And here we see Chaim Tao together with Ivry Gitlis. He is 98 already, so special people. And of course, late Ida Handel, who recently passed away. Here is together with legendary Russian violinist and pedagogue Edward Grachko as well, many years already part of the Keshet Eilon faculty. I as well would like to mention our doctors of instruments who working in the really state-of-the-art atelier in the building where the library. We can see here Daniel Schmidt, Korman, and Finkelstein. So this is our team of the people who are looking after the instruments. And of course, our office. We can see now the photos of the office. Here in this office, you know, everyone is a vital part of the engine that moved Keshet Eilon forward. What an A team, always working around the clock and making Keshet Eilon such engine that everybody amazed that in no place in the world people treated the way they're treated at Keshet Eilon. So I decided today not to be too modest. Forgive me. And now, you know, to move into the virtual world, we needed right specialist, world-class specialist. And we found one in Israel, Vadim Bailey. He is a technological wizard. He is our door to the outside world. Vadim, I know you're sitting now somewhere behind the screen. So I send you from all of us big, big thank you for what you achieve on our behalf. And I mentioned in the beginning the archery, so because Keshet Eilon is not just about the music. We're doing sport, and we here see students here training with great enthusiasm, sometimes even more enthusiasm than the practicing room. But sport hall have their own dynamic. And as well, I would like to introduce you the coaches, the Olympic team coaches who are training students. And just a day before opening of this master course, we learned very sad news that our head coach for many years, Fima Khayutin, only 59 years old, passed away. So it was really very shocking news for us. We will miss you, Fima. Rest in peace. Well, so we continue. Looking back, you know, I can say with pride that we had an incredible, incredible 30 years of creativity. Because very often when I speak about Keshet Eilon, people are surprised how clearly I remember what happened years ago. But for me, it is very easy because I witnessed so many truly unforgettable events. One of the first events like this happened in 1998, when Keshet Eilon was invited by Keren Hayesod to present Israel at the celebration of the 50th anniversary of the State of Israel at the Berlin Deutsche Oper Hall. Present at the concert were members of the German Bundestag and Knesset, and one of the speakers was Mikhail Gorbachev. You can see now Gorbachev speaking at this event. It was really a moment of pride of Keshet Eilon. Only after 8 years of existence, and suddenly we received such honor to represent country in so high level event. And we can see now our next photograph, Shlomo Mintz and alumni of Keshet Eilon, performed with the Deutsche Opera Orchestra Tchaikovsky Concerto, each one playing different movement. And proceeds of the event were used to build the first three faculty residence of the new campus. I would like to show you this photograph of our three beautiful villas. Receipts of the funds was held for some time, and after some behind the scenes queries by Gilad and the administration and the board from the Keren Yesod Israel, it turned out that the donation would come from Geneva and not from Berlin. So from the legacy of the Wallach-Faller family of Switzerland. This impressive village, villas, which were designed by architect Tzadik Eliakim, and to this day are used by professors and students, were opened in 2002. We can see now the photograph of the opening. The show representative of the donors is the CEO of Keren Hayesod, Gad Ben Ari. And today there's a sign on the site display the names of the donors on the next photograph. Yes. And now the next really unforgettable event happened in 2004 as a result of the efforts of Edward Grach and the Israel Embassy in Moscow. Gala concert took place at the Grand Hall of the famous Tchaikovsky Conservatory in Moscow. I would like to show you the report from the Russian TV of this event.
Московская филармония предоставила одну из лучших мировых концертных площадок, большой зал Московской консерватории, для осуществления совместного проекта. Гала-концерта Камерного оркестра Московия и международных мастер-классов Keshet Eilon, Израиль. Мастер-классы Keshet Eilon – один из самых успешных и интересных музыкальных проектов Израиля. В Keshet Eilon прошли обучение многие из ныне признанных мировых знаменитостей. Открыли концерт мастера. В концертной симфонии Моцарта для скрипки, альта и оркестра выступили известная скрипачка Аня Шнарх и художественный руководитель и дирижер оркестра Московия Эдуард Грач. Оба преподаватели мастер-классов Keshet Eilon. В концерте для трех скрипок и оркестра Антонио Вивальди к ним присоединился музыкальный директор мастер-классов Keshet Eilon, всемирно известный педагог и скрипач Itzhak Rashkovsky. Во второй части концерта выступили молодые музыканты, в большинстве своем выпускники мастер-классов Keshet Eilon. Чарльз Ян, Великобритания, Семен Гавриков из Израиля, россиянин Никита Борисоглебский и Гай Казанян из Еревана, представитель Кореи Хьюк Юкван и Алена Баева из Казахстана, Юлия Гонина из Беларуси.
Это был последний концерт в этом сезоне моего абонемента в Большом зале. Играет и дирижирует Эдуард Грач. Это ежегодный абонемент Московской филармонии. Но у меня возникла идея, так как я каждый год, вот уже 7 лет, езжу в Израиль, в Keshet Eilon, на мастер-классы. Это, с моей точки зрения, одни из самых лучших мастер-классов в мире сейчас. По своему уровню, по уровню педагогическому, по уровню скрипачей, которые туда приезжают, по отношению, по доброте, по обстановке, по этому духу, который там царит.
And now Carnegie Hall. In 2008, with the support of Angelika Berry, Raya Strauss, Ben Dror, and the American friends of Keshet Eilon, we held a gala concert at Carnegie Hall, and then another in 2010, also supported by Raya Strauss-Bertor, with the support of the American Friends Committee. Here we see the performance and the photograph, the performance of this concert together with all committee members after the concert in 2008. I would like to show you from this concert, Vivaldi concerto, the quality of the recording, not really great, but this is only the evidence which we have, at which Ida Handel, Ani Schnarch, and the students performing together. So please, let's hear. of the most profound and important innovation ideas of our longtime friend Yardena Baroyan, implemented by Gilad, was the establishment of Keshet Eilon Friends Committees around the world, who organize and continue to organize fundraising concerts in London, Geneva, New York, New Jersey, Washington, Houston, San Francisco, Miami, California, Paris, Sydney, Israel, to name but a few. You know, I really prevent myself from mentioning the names, because I don't want to miss any name, because everybody is so important. But I will just mention the first concert. The first concert, which took place in 1998 in London, in the residence of Malka and Leon. This concert really opened the doors for others and show what can be done. Malka and Amnon Leon. And after this, it was like domino effects. All these concerts appear and help us with our fundraising campaign. I would like to show you just one performance from this kind of concerts. Here's a took place in Miami in the 2018 at the Alexander home, at which Lea Zhu is just 11-year-old graduate of Keshet Eilon, performing with the pianist Rustam Rakhmedov La Campanella by Paganini. Told you the brief, really very, very brief 30 years history of Keshet Eilon. Again, I must admit that when we started in 1990, we didn't have the conditions to hold a major international master course at Kibbutz Eilon. There was no suitable quality pianos, no air conditioners, no proper teaching and practicing facilities, or even office. The first office, a small room in Caravan, where if you stood in the middle of the room, you could touch all the walls around. Gilad received only several years later. Today, he can smile with a sense of achievement and even occasionally lean back and put his feet on the desk. It's okay, Gilad, you can do it. And then back in 1990s, my office was just outside of the dining hall. Here I was preparing the programs of Keshet Eilon. Today I have a concert hall, so no complaint from my side now. And Keshet Eilon is probably the only master course in the world that is constructing his facilities. During the year, these facilities are used for the seminars of young Israeli string players. We can see now the next photograph, young string players gathering at the Kibbutz Eilon, and teachers, about 60, 80 young string players from all parts of the country attend the seminars, benefiting from the experience of Keshet Eilon faculty. Jews, Christians, Muslims, you know, students playing together. And this is the essence of Keshet Eilon. As Gilad often saying, Keshet in Hebrew is a rainbow, a bridge between cultures, people, and nations that bring people together, especially in this turbulent time. We use as well our beautiful Baruyan concert hall to hold an annual concert series. We can see now the next photograph. Yes, here is the audience coming to hear concert during the year. And so we're bringing the culture to the Galilee. So what's the secret of Keshet Eilon succeeding for 30 years? My explanation is it's very simple. The recipe for success was a fortunate combination of circumstances. Kibbutz Eilon, its members, who wanted to bring culture to their kibbutz, the wave of new immigrants who injected energy into the social and cultural life of the country, an outstanding faculty who attracted the most talented students from Israel and around the world, and the coming together of the group of very special people, Gilad, Amnon, Ani, I, Shlomo later. So this vision, a driving force in the development of Keshet Eilon from the beginning, was clearly expressed by Gilad back in 1996. Let's hear what Gilad said then.
Right afterwards, we'll go to see the swimming pool, and most important, even more than the swimming pool, that from the swimming pool, you can see when you'll come in a few years ahead where the Keshet Eilon Center will be built. That's the most important place, so I'll show you in a minute, okay? In the meantime, I can only show you the vision or the dream. So, you see this row of pines. That's the place that we're going to have like a music village with an auditorium, with everything, with the view to the Mediterranean Sea. You can see it over there. And this mountain up there on the hill, it's Kibbutz Adamit, and behind it, it's Lebanon. And I'm sure that people that will come here will be far from any civilization, will do their best to produce the best music. So we hope that we'll see you in these beautiful buildings that will come soon, sooner the better. Okay?
Yes. I would like to tell you the truth. When Gilad spoke then, I was smiling in disbelief. I didn't know what he's talking about. Now I see how he was right with his vision. Thank you, Gilad. Today we can say it with great sense of pride that our dream has become reality. More than 1,400 graduates from 50 countries, and more than 50 countries, are our ambassadors around the world, spreading the message that Israel is not just about the wars and violence. I think this evening not only does Keshet Eilon look back with pride as it summarizes its achievements, but even more importantly, it views the past 30 years as an example and driving force for the future. We are not stopping. Our next task is to complete the building of the campus and to establish a permanent music school which will function throughout the whole year. We can't imagine Keshet Eilon without the Friends Committees in Israel and over the world who have accompanied us over the years, and for that we offer you our enormous, huge, heartfelt gratitude. Together with you, and only together with you, we cannot do it on our own. Together with you, we will continue to make music. And I would like to finish this presentation with Keshet Eilon Ensemble performing Elgar's Salute Damour at the final concert at in Tel Aviv Opera House in 2017. Salute Damour. This is our salute of love to all friends of Keshet Eilon. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome back. Welcome to Zoom. Welcome everybody. Thank you for being with us now, dear friends, so we can now talk to each other. Okay, we can now.
Thank you so much, Itzhak, Izia, my dear friend, and thank you all for joining us. It's really a pride and a pleasure, and you did such a great presentation. Of course, there are plenty
Rashkovsky.
Oh, Mika. Yes. No. It's okay, it's okay. Эдуард, откройте микрофон, откройте микрофон, можно открыть микрофон.
Рациты рак лаудот, кама шата ицлахта, лави акол бияха, зман ма. Yeah, a very, very nice illustrated for a long, long time.
Thank you, thank you, Mika. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Just to mention, please.
I am excited for everything. In the Gilad, Beruti, I know them a long time, and their behavior for everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Omika. Thank you.
Your contribution.
Okay, I can see Eduard Grach. Welcome from Moscow.
Очень было приятно все это увидеть, всех вас увидеть.
It was very pleasant to see all of us. I'm translating as usual. Я перевожу.
Okay. Да, брат, что ты переводишь.
Очень рад. Мне
very happy.
Я не сумел на мастер-классах любимого мною.
Well, he's sorry that he didn't congratulate Хайм Тау. He missed Хайм Тау.
Я хотел его поздравить.
He didn't manage to congratulate Хайм Тау. Is Хайм Тау now here? Anybody knows if Хайм Тау is us? If Хайм Тау here?
Health.
Health, yes. Okay. So maybe it's not here. Okay.
This is a замечательный доклад.
Thank you.
Как приятно это все увидеть.
Very nice to hear.
Концерты в Москве.
Moscow concert, yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Beautiful.
I see Rachel from New York. Rachel, how are you? You almost is us.
I am so moved. It was so fabulous, so moving. So many years together. I love
yes,
it.
Yes, you're right.
Thank you. Thank you, Gilad. Thank you, Nitsa. Thank you. Itzhak, you did a great
job.
Hi, Rachel. Izia.
Oh, hi, Neshikot. And let's
next time. Yes, Rami, I didn't have time to be in contact with you. I'm sorry.